Have you heard the crazy word astigmatism and wondering what it is? And if you have it, well, buckle up. In this video, I describe exactly what it is and what symptoms you may be having if you have astigmatism. Let's focus in. Howdy everybody, I'm Dr. Neil Guymon, Dr. Eye Guy, with the show that focuses on keeping your eyes the healthiest and your vision the clearest. I do a lot of educational videos just like this one, as well as how-to and review videos. Subscribe for my future Eye Guy videos and also check below for any additional links and my Eye Guy recommendations. Otherwise, let's focus on astigmatism. Now, what is astigmatism? When I tell patients that they have astigmatism, it sounds horrible. It's the worst sounding word that I usually can tell patients. It sounds like an evil disease and almost makes you think that you have an instant death sentence. But I'm here to tell you it's not an evil disease and you won't go blind from it. People usually think when they hear the word astigmatism that it's separated out, so astigmatism or astigma, or maybe just the word stigmatism, but it's actually combined, astigmatism. Now the meaning of the word comes from the Greek a, so meaning without, and then stigma, meaning spot, without spot. And that's exactly what astigmatism does. Now your eye is designed to focus light to a single point on the back of your eye so that you can see things clearly. Even people that have nearsightedness or farsightedness, they're still able to focus that light to a single point, but maybe it's just not where that point should be. People that have astigmatism, it does not focus it to a single point. Instead, that point is stretched out. Now, it's estimated that 33% of the people in the world have astigmatism. That's 1 in 3 people are walking around with astigmatism. In fact, if you wear glasses or contacts right now, you have a 70% chance that you have astigmatism as well. Now, astigmatism is all about the curvature of your eye. The common place where people have this curvature to it is the cornea. The cornea is that clear portion of the eye that covers the color part of the eye, the iris. This is where a contact would sit. Now, a common analogy that many doctors use will say, hey, you have astigmatism, so your eye is shaped like a football. People that don't have astigmatism, their eye is shaped like a basketball. Usually what they mean by that, if you have a spherical prescription or no astigmatism at all, that means that your cornea has the same curve to it no matter which direction that you go. So it's kind of like a sphere, like a basketball. Now if you have astigmatism, they'll use the analogy that your eye is shaped like a football, meaning that you have one section of your cornea that has a curve to it, and then another section of your cornea has a steeper curve to it, more of a curve than the other one, making it not uniform around. Now, if you have a cornea that has different curves depending on what direction that you're measuring, that's what causes that point to be stretched and not focus on a single point. One portion of your eye is focusing for a certain point while the other portion of the eye is focusing for a different point, and that's what stretches that image out. Another common place to have astigmatism is actually called lenticular astigmatism, or you'll have this curvature inside the lens. The lens is right behind the iris, the color part of the eye, and you can have that same type of astigmatism or different curves to this lens that can cause astigmatism. Now, most people that have astigmatism have regular astigmatism, meaning that astigmatism follows certain types of rules. The curvature that we measure usually will be on a 90-degree axis from each other. So if you have a steeper curve in this area and a flatter curve there, they usually kind of follow that same rule depending on where your curve of your eye is. Now there's some people that have irregular astigmatism, meaning they don't follow the same rules. Those people that have irregular astigmatism usually have a condition. Now one of these conditions that can cause irregular astigmatism is called keratoconus. Keratoconus is kind of like having a beer belly or a dad bod belly right on your cornea. The cornea will have a normal curve, but all of a sudden this little bulge will show up, causing irregular astigmatism or irregular curvature to it. Hey, let me know down in the comments if you thought I was going to say beer belly or dad bod belly in this video about astigmatism. Now, how do we correct for astigmatism? Luckily, most people that have regular astigmatism can be corrected with glasses, contacts, or even surgery like LASIK or PRK. Now people that have these irregular astigmatisms, there's also corrections there. Sometimes you can correct the vision with glasses, can be a little bit more difficult just because of that irregular curve, but there's contact lenses as well. Like I mentioned before, specialty contacts called scleral lenses can correct for that irregular cornea very well and give people actually very good vision. There's also hybrid lenses that have a hard lens in the middle with a soft lens skirt around it to try and help with the comfort of hard lenses. So there's definitely options out there for your astigmatism, depending on what type of astigmatism you have. You'll want to go in and check with your eye doctor to see what kind of options are out there for you. Now for the part of the video to see if you might have astigmatism. Now if you're wearing glasses right now, one trick that you can do is actually take the glasses off and hold them right out in front of you. Now I want you to find something with a straight edge, maybe the door opening, the side of the TV, or a window. Now I want you to look at that straight edge and I want you to rotate your glasses from left to right. If you notice that straight edge is also rotating or distorting, you likely have astigmatism correction in your glasses. Here's a little example of an astigmatism lens when I kind of rotate it looking at me. Do you see how I kind of distort a little bit? I might look weird and my face gets thinner or fatter. And now here's a lens that does not have any astigmatism correction in it. It's just for nearsightedness. And I'm rotating it, you can see it doesn't distort my face or anything. Now if you have contacts and you're wondering if you have astigmatism correction in your contacts, usually it will say it on the box. It will either say toric lenses or it will actually say that you have contacts for astigmatism. Another way you can tell is if you look at the side of the box, it'll have different sets of numbers. And one that's labeled CYL, that stands for cylinder, if you have that on your box of contacts, then you have astigmatism correction in your contacts. I'm just gonna run real quick through a prescription, glasses prescription or contact lens prescription, so you can know if you have astigmatism correction in there as well. If you have your printed out prescription from your doctor, let's take a look. So here's an example of what a basic printout of a prescription might look like. I'll do a quick run through of what all these mean. I'll have a video coming out shortly about how to read your prescription exactly. But over here on the left you have OD and OS, meaning right eye and left eye. OD is right eye, OS is left eye. Now this first section here that's labeled sphere, that usually indicates whether you're nearsighted or you're farsighted. Now the next section is what I want you to pay attention to. It's labeled CYL or cylinder. That is the amount of astigmatism that you have in your prescription. Now in that third section, the axis, that is in degrees. So 180 degrees for the right eye, 90 degrees for the left eye. And that is indicating where the flat portion of your cornea is at. And this axis number is important so they can orient the glasses or the contacts to match the correct curvatures of your eye. Now if you do not have astigmatism correction in your prescription, in the cylinder section, you'll either see a zero or sometimes it'll be left blank. Sometimes you'll see the letters DS for dioptric sphere. Either way, if you're not seeing a number or a number in the axis section, then likely you do not have astigmatism in your correction. Now let's say you don't know if you have astigmatism and you're wondering what kind of symptoms you might be experiencing if you have astigmatism. So let me show you some examples of what you might be experiencing if you have astigmatism. So this is with 6 diopters of astigmatism, quite a bit here, and you can see definitely blurs the vision, distorts it, and then here's 90 degrees away. And here is the letter chart with 6 diopters of astigmatism. Definitely making things fuzzy, not as crisp. We'll go 90 degrees away. This makes you sick just looking at it here. Stretching the image. It's not a single point versus, boom, single point and clear. Here's an example of what it might look like driving at night with astigmatism. I use Christmas lights as the example because astigmatism really does stretch out those points of light. Instead of making one single point, it stretches out, makes it blurry and distorted. Astigmatism definitely causes blur and usually can cause a blur at all distances. It can be far away, it can be close up, it can be on your computer, it can be the dashboard. Like I said, because it doesn't focus a light to a single point, that blur can come from any distance that you're looking at. People usually experience this blur or distortion more at nighttime. A lot of times when I have patients that come in the clinic and they say, hey, I see well, but maybe at nighttime when I'm driving at night, my vision is just not as clear. That's usually the first thought that comes into my head, is they probably have astigmatism. Now this blur, sometimes people will say it almost looks like a stretched image, or sometimes people will use the word double vision or a ghosting image that comes off letters or certain things that they're looking at. Now up close, it can cause the blur and distortion, but it makes it tricky for the eyes to focus on things. So people that read for long amounts of time, or they're using the computer all day long, sometimes it can cause eye strain and headaches because the eye just doesn't know where to focus because it doesn't have a single point that it's looking at. Your eye will almost act like a camera or a camera lens trying to find that best focal point. And so sometimes the vision will kind of go in and out. People will have to blink to get it clear, and it'll go clear, but then the vision will go out again, and then they'll have to bring it back. So sometimes people will say that I just have this in and out clarity of vision when I'm on the computer. Sometimes it's good, and sometimes it'll blink, and that's bad. And when it's constantly doing this, it'll cause the eye to strain and cause their eyes to hurt, and sometimes they'll get a headache. And so they'll come into the clinic saying, hey, I get headaches and strain when I'm on the computer. What can I do? One possible reason is because they have astigmatism that is uncorrected for, and their eyes are just constantly trying to find the best focal point, and they strain out and get tired. Now, if you're having any of these symptoms that I just showed you, definitely a good idea to make an appointment for an eye exam to see if you have astigmatism, because glasses or contacts definitely can help people with astigmatism. Remember to comment below for any questions that you might have about astigmatism or anything else. I am here to help. Hey, and remember to go check out my other videos. I'll put a link right up here. Hey, thanks for watching. Again, I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, committed to looking out for you and your eyes. Stay focused, and I'll see you in the next video.